Last time then, we were looking at the idea of cancellation tokens and how you can use them to signal from outside of a task that you want the task to terminate, and then the signal arrives inside the task and does whatever processing you want it to do to shut down in a friendly way. But something that's very closely related to that is the idea of having a progress indicator, so that while the task is going along, it can indicate to the outside world how far through it's got, so you can make decisions as to whether indeed you do want to cancel. So let's have a look at that. And what I'm going to do here is just pick straight up from the example we had last time. So just to recap that, we had this application for calculating the number of prime numbers in a certain range. So where we left that off, we had it looking something like this. So that's pre-filled in for the range 20 million to 40 million. You'll remember we could keep an eye on the CPUs, and I could click the calculate button, and it would start trying to calculate how many numbers there are in that range. And we did it in three slightly different ways, and we just got back the result from the one that was fastest, so it was task two in that case. But at the moment, we've got no indication of progress, so that's what we want to add in. And let's do the first bit of that to simply add in the visuals of it on the GUI. So we'll go to our XAML for that window. We'll add in another row, just the same definition as the first row. And then into that row, we can put a standard control, which is a thing called a progress bar. And I'll give that a name of progress bar. And then I'll actually just nick quite a bit of stuff from the previous item, the list box. So that's going to have the grid row of two, the new one we created, but we still want to span all of them. Still have the margin of 2. I'm also going to give it a height of 20, like we have for some of the other elements. And then also, I'm going to give this an initial visibility of collapsed, because the idea is we only want to see this when it's doing the calculation, not all the time. So if we pull all of that on there, that should get that working. And then, obviously, given it's collapsed, we've got to make it visible. So in the actual code, where we have the calculate click, so there, remember, we enabled the cancel button, but what I'll also do is on the progress bar, I'm going to set that visibility, but obviously here, I want that now to be visibility.visible. And then when we finish the calculation, so I'll put this in the finally block, because that will mean it'll happen however the calculation finishes, then on there, I am going to set it to collapsed. And then the one other thing we'll do is on the progress bar, when we start out, we'll set the value to 0. So just initialize it. Just to look at the defaults there, if we go back in here and look at the properties, you can see that by default, a progress bar works in a range of 0 through to 100, so a percentage, which is simple enough. So that's what we'll use there. And if we do that, then when we run this up and drag that over, and so now if we click calculate, we can see the progress bar has appeared on the bottom. Not got anything in there as yet, obviously. And then if we cancel that, then we cancelled it, went through the finally block, and the progress bar disappeared. So that's the UI part of it. Now let's actually put in some code to track that progress. And just to simplify things to start with, you remember we were kicking off these three tasks with the random variations on the algorithm. Well, let's start out with just the one task so that we can see how this progress is going to work. And what we can do is we can here create an object that we'll call progress. And then we're going to set this to a class called progress, which is a generic for the progress information that you're going to be sending back. Now, in our case, we are running through the numbers from low to high, and those are ulongs. So let's make that a ulong as to what we're going to have. And then we need to have an event handler on that progress that's going to respond when the progress is updated. So that's progress.progressChanged, and we'll do a plus equals. That then will take a lambda, and just like any other event handler, it's going to take two parameters. The first one is going to be the sender, which we're not interested in, so we're just going to do a discard. But then we're going to have the value that's been sent back, which is going to be the position we are in our range from low to high. Let's give that lambda a body. And then what we need to do is take that value and convert it into a percentage. So we'll say var percentage equals, and then first thing we're going to do is get that value and subtract from it the low end of the range. So if the value is in the range 20 million to 40 million, we want something that's in the range from 0 to 20 million, so we do that. We then pop that in brackets, and we're going to multiply that by 100 because we're dealing with a percentage, and then we'll divide that by the total range, high minus low, so that should give us the percentage 0 through to 100. And then we just have to take our progress bar and pop that value, the percentage, into there. Now, obviously, progress bar is a GUI control, and we know that the fundamental rule when you're dealing with tasks and threads in a GUI application is that you can only interact with GUI controls in the main thread. And that's handled for us automatically here, because the way this progress changed event on our progress object works is it guarantees to run this back in the main thread, because the purpose of this is communicating the progress from within our task out to the GUI. So we're allowed to access that without any issues. So that's how we're going to update. Now we're going to need to pass that progress item into our function that's running in the task. So we'll just pop the progress in there, and then we can add that on as an extra parameter to the prime count. And if we have a look at that, you can see that it's there, got this progress for you long. Actually, probably a good idea not in here to use the actual class, but to use the interface IProgress, because that will focus us on only the things that we should be doing from inside the task, which is updating the progress. But also it does mean that if we decided to have some different implementation of this interface, we could still use that and this code will work in the same way. So that's what we've got there. And then all we really need to do here is, in our loop that's taking us through from low to high, where we previously were testing for the cancellation, we will put at the end of it, it doesn't really matter, but we're saying that this particular item's been done, and we can just say progress dot, and then we have this report, and that takes whatever the generic type is. So this, remember, is IProgress for ulong, because our number is a ulong, so that's what can go in there. So that will now report that progress back. And that should be all we need to do. But if we run that up, and let's just keep an eye on what's going on in the processing there, if I click calculate, we can see that the memory is rocketing, the CPU usage is minimal, and the entire application is frozen. So you see my mouse is now not even changing its cursor. But it's really not good at all. So we're going to want to terminate that and try and work out what the problem was there. You might be thinking, well, we're clearly calling this progress very frequently. So we're calling it 20 million times in the overall space of that 20 million to 40 million calculation. And so maybe the progress bar that we're updating here just can't take that many updates. Well, that could well be part of the problem. But even if we remove that and do the same thing again, then you can see, even with it not trying to do anything at all in terms of actually processing it, it's still getting into this trouble. It's still completely hung up. And the reason is, in fact, entirely to do with this rather nice feature that when this progress changed callback is called, it's done on the main thread so that you can access GUI elements like the progress bar. But remember how that works. Whenever you have something that's signaled from a task, from another thread, that wants to come back into the GUI thread, that's handled by popping a message onto the message queue, which is then handled by the message loop, as it frequently deals with all sorts of messages, different events like mouse movements, button clicks, and all that sort of thing. But if you consider what's happening here, remember we are calling that report 20 million times over the space of this particular example, which means even if this event handler does nothing, it's still got to be placed on the message queue 20 million times. And that just chokes everything. It means nothing else can get in there, and that's why it's hanging up. So this actually is a bad way to do this. What you really have to do is filter down the number of calls you're making, not here, because by this point it's too late, but you have to do it actually in the place where they're being raised. Now, you could probably wrap it up in a different class just to make life a bit easier, but the important thing is it's got to be running as part of the task, not back in the main thread where the GUI is running. So what we're going to have to do is something slightly different. We're going to have to report the percentage and only report it when the percentage changes, rather than reporting every different number. So the first step we need to make there actually is we need to change the progress from reporting a ulong to simply reporting an int, because that's all we need for our percentage. And that means we need to change that down here as well. And then we basically need to take that calculation, and instead we need to be calculating that down here. So if we put that in there, change that to num, and then pass in the percentage there. Also, we've got the slight problem that percentage is going to be a ulong, because that's what num and low and high are. We want an int, so we're going to have to cast all of that to an int. There is one slight performance issue that's not going to be a huge one, but I don't like it, is that that bit of the calculation is going to be the same every time. So if we're calling this quite frequently, we don't want to be wasting time on that. So actually, I'm going to take that, and up here, I'm going to say var factor equals, and then pop that in there. But for reasons that I'm sure many of you will spot, but I will explain later, I'm going to make that actually 100.0 rather than 100. And so down here, I will multiply that by factor, so we're not doing the calculation every time. Also though, remember, we only want to report this if the percentage changes. So I'm also going to say var old percentage equals 0. And then here we'll say if percentage is greater than old percentage, then we'll report the percentage and we'll say old percentage equals percentage. So that should now make it so that it's only going to report this basically 100 times when that percentage changes. Then back up here, we now simply need to change this, and it can be much, much simpler because we can simply have a one line lambda, which is going to say progress bar value equals value. It already is a percentage, so we don't need to do any of the calculations. And so now if we run that up, we can see if I do calculate, we've got the progress bar appearing, it's increasing, we haven't got that lockup, we haven't got that horrible use of memory, so it's going through, showing us where we are, and then disappears when we've finished and gives us the result. So really doing exactly what we wanted to do. Could argue actually that that progress bar is a bit jumpy because we did it as a percentage, as an integer. That means it's going to only have 100 steps. So maybe we'd like to do it a bit more fine-tuned than that, but I can leave it to you to work that out for yourself. Just to show you the thing about the 100.0, this is an old chestnut in C-style languages generally, where if we look at what's happening there, that factor is a double, because although high and low were just ulongs, because I've put the 0.0 on there, that means that's a double. That means the whole calculation is done as a double. Problem is, if I were just to put the integer in there, then when I run that up, although it still doesn't freeze up, you can see we're getting no progress whatsoever being indicated. And the reason for that is that it's doing integer division, and high minus low, in this case 20 million, vastly bigger than 100, integer division, you just get 0. Whereas by putting the 100.0, it does floating point division and you get a reasonable number. The reason that that didn't go wrong before, when we had it looking like that, I didn't need to put it in there, because in this case, those are evaluated left to right. And so this number, num minus low times 100, is going to be substantially bigger than high minus low. And so the integer division will be okay. But once we put it in a different expression, then you've got to remember to make sure that you have the floating point division. So that's why we had to put that in there. something that's fundamental in C-style languages and just occasionally still nowadays crops up, and you can make a mistake if you get that wrong. But that's got that all working. We've still got one further thing to do, however, which is we've got to restore the fact that we previously had these multiple alternative algorithms running in parallel, and we were getting the results of the first one. So let's put that back in there now. So all we've got to do is uncomment those two and then pop in the progress that we now know we need to pass in there. And all perfectly safe in terms of threading, because remember, it ensures that this event handler only gets called in the main thread. So if we run that up and now do the calculate, well, now, if you look at that progress bar, it's all being a bit weird because it's jumping around, flashing forwards and backwards. It still eventually will get to the end and give you the result, but it wasn't very nice. And the reason for that, I think, is pretty obvious. Remember, we've got these three tasks precisely because they work in different ways based on the fact we had that randomization that we can see in there of the order that we were doing the tests in. And so, given that some of those are going to run faster and some slower, that's why if we simply report the percentage, it's going to jump around because you'll have had a high value from the faster ones and a low value from the lower one. It's pretty easy to fix because the whole point of this is we are going to finish the work when the fastest one finishes. So the percentage done is always going to be the fastest percentage we've got. So all three tasks are going to report their percentage. But then up here, when we use it, easiest thing to do is just make sure we only use the largest one. So we can just say math.max, and then the max of the value we're being offered, or the current value we've got on the progress bar. And so now we'll see that it runs smoothly, progressively once again, but what it's always showing us is the task that has the highest level of completion, and then when it hits 100, that completes, and that's working fine. So fairly straightforward, the idea of what we have with progress. We've got the generic class progress and the generic interface iProgress. We can put in whatever type we want to indicate the progress, but be a little bit careful because the way that it works in terms of jumping between the threads means each time you report progress, it's putting another message on the message queue. You want to keep that relatively low. Certainly you don't want that to be in the millions, because we saw it completely destroyed the whole application, and indeed it really slowed down the whole operating system. So you need to be turning it, in our case, into a percentage or something minimal within the task, not outside the task. But I hope that was useful. Progress and cancellation working side by side to give us quite a nice user experience whereby users can see what's happening, can decide whether to cancel. Still plenty more to look at in terms of tasks, so we've got quite a few more videos to come on that. But if you want to see those, do subscribe. If you enjoyed this video, do click like, and I'll see you next time.